Hello and welcome to the Music Smoothie.
Is my audio low for you? Because I have a new mic, so you guys might want to turn me up.
I can pump you up if needed. I can pump you.
Pump me.
And on that note, welcome back to another episode of the Music Smoothie. Yes, Billy, we've been recording this whole time.
Oh.
That all stays in.
Yeah, absolutely.
Beautiful.
I've been bamboozled.
And remember, I want someone to love me. That's what I fucking want. And today we've got a lovely lineup for you. We got Billy. I swear to God, this is becoming a running joke.
Sorry. That's me.
That's you. And we've got Aleph.
Q-teen!
All right. So this episode, we might get a little weird on you. We might bring out some weird stuff because... Well, it's just the three of us, and we get up to stinky business, as they say.
We get up to shenanigans.
Ooh, I made absolutely a stinky.
Great. Uh-oh, stinky.
I made some stinky weird music. Guess what? I'm playing indie today. It's so weird.
Ooh. He pulls out, he finds the one Arctic Monkeys song that doesn't have under 10 million plays, or doesn't have over 10 million plays.
Guys, this is some weird shit, I'm telling you.
I'm not like other girls.
Alright, up next we got Brick by Brick by the Arctic Monkeys.
Beautiful.
Oh, absolutely. Alright, so, I guess I'm going to go first, and I'm going to let my hair down with some early 90s post-punk. So I hope you guys can dig it. It's not super weird, but we're just getting into it, you know? We're just sort of feeling it out, and we're going to go from there.
Yeah, the cock's still in the bag, but it'll be released.
Yeah. Release the cock. Release the cock cut. The cut cock.
Yeah.
I don't know what I'm... Alright.
Good answer!
This... This is Knuckles the Dog by Killdozer. Oh, good. It didn't work.
Where's Knuckles?
Knuckles the dog.
Knuckles fights Sonic, and then he punches Sonic in the face. Sonic breaks his teeth, but he goes so fast, his hands phase into Knuckles' chest, and he pulls out Knuckles' heart. But he's going so fast now that he goes around Knuckles, and he disintegrates him into dust, and he eats his heart. He digests Knuckles so fast. His digestive system is so fucking fast. Sonic has become a cannibal.
Keep going.
He goes around the city. He terrorizes people. And Dr. Robotnik has to stop him.
I am in horror at what I am hearing. Lash, please fix the plot as quickly as possible.
This has become a shitty, like, fan fiction podcast.
Yeah.
Dr. Robotnik goes to Tails. Tails is so scared. Tails gets the gun out of his closet and he looks at it and he wants to, but he can't. He says he has to fight and kill Sonic himself.
We need more violent fanfics. Too many fanfics of love stories between characters that just shouldn't have. Oh! Is it working?
I just added the new bot.
Thank you, Fred Boat.
Don't worry, I'm not going to make Sonic and Tails fuck yet. That happens in the third chapter.
I am terrified.
I feel like one of my songs I just want to listen to and like kind of zone out, and that's the reason why I'm playing a 13 minute and 43 second song.
That's totally a valid reason to listen to a song, so figure out why the fuck the song isn't working.
I just need to boot up Baldur's Gate. That's what I'm missing in my life right now.
Yeah. Alright, that's Knuckles the dog who helps people by Killdozer. And how did you feel about that, Aleph?
Mute button. That was interesting. The instrumentals went crazy, but I was very much not about the vocals, and it was very much not about the lyrics. It's kind of, to me, it kind of sounded like it was written by a 5-year-old. Which if I find out that, like, it was or something, and they were like, yo, let's just record this, that'd make it, like, wholesome 100. The instrumentals went crazy, though. Like, I liked the big noise buildup at the end. I kind of wish that they had done the fade-out thing, like, on I Want You, She's So Heavy by the Beatles. Like, that was kind of what I was hearing in my head. But it was, that part went crazy, but overall, I wasn't too huge on this, but I wouldn't write off this the entirety of this band's material just based off this song. Like, I'm like, they could have some bangers that I really vibe with.
Yeah, this band definitely has music that you might not appreciate initially, but it grows on you. That's how I take it anyway.
Yeah, no, I could see it growing on me. I don't know, it's just it is bizarre. Post-punk in general is, like, I think something that, well, first of all, I object to the label of post-punk because it's so hard to, like, if somebody calls something post-punk, I have no clue if they're applying a misnomer or not, because it feels like everything is post-punk.
Everything is post-punk. We are post-punk.
If a music nerd calls it post-punk, it is post... No, if a music nerd likes it, it's post-punk. Therefore, Bjork is post-punk.
Death Grips.
In this video essay, I will. Yeah, no, it was very interesting, though. At least it certainly wasn't boring. I won't say it was boring.
That's fair. Hey, Billy, I know you didn't hear as much of it. What did you think of it?
Yeah, for the audience, I have Fredboat muted, so I didn't realize there was something.
What's happening? Oh, for the audience, Billy just dropped out of the call. He died. Very sad.
This is the saddest thing I have ever heard. One like equals one prayer to return Billy to the call.
Yeah, we'll start a change.org petition to bring Billy back into the call.
Yes, link in bio. Check that out. Definitely consider throwing a few bucks this way. And we'll get the Supreme Court on this.
Yeah. Oh, Kavanaugh's dying to weigh in.
Oh man. This is a sad day.
Yeah.
I like to imagine he's just talking through all of his points and he doesn't even realize that he left the call.
Looks like he's offline.
He either accidentally closed Discord or his Discord just crashed.
I'm gonna call this the cursed movie.
Oh, he's back!
Hey, Billy!
Wow. Everything is just fucking with me. I'm back.
I was just telling Aleph we're probably gonna call this the cursed smoothie.
Yeah, there you go. Things just keep happening for me. First, Fredboat was like muted, so I didn't know if songs was playing. And then I finished my installation for the driver, so I can play Baldur's Gate 3, and I didn't know the installation would close my Discord for some reason. And I was talking like funny. It closed out Discord right when you asked me, what did you think, Billy? And I thought I was just talking to you guys, and then
I thought we were being really good listeners.
Yeah, you guys are such good listeners. Finally someone will understand and listen to me and won't talk over me, and it feels so good.
Just a reminder, if there aren't people actively being rude to you, your Discord probably crashed.
That is actually a good rule.
Good rule of thumb.
But yeah, what I was saying was that I actually feel like I like this, especially the vocals, for all the reasons Aleph didn't like it. I think that it really makes a uncanny, idyllic, kind of childlike nature of the vocals and those instruments like kind of coalescing with it in a fun, uncanny way. They're definitely instrumentally talented, and I love the repetitive nature of the vocals. It's weird because I feel like some songs I really feel like I have to nitpick the repetitive nature of something, but this kind of brought me in. And like I said, I kind of am in the mood to just listen to a song and zone out right now. So this is what I needed. When I finally grew a brain and realized Fred Boat was muted, so I probably listened to 3 minutes of a 5-minute song.
Something along those lines.
Yeah. I feel like that's it's very much intentional for the uncanny childlike quality.
Yeah, I could see that. Like the idea of contrasting like the sort of childlike quality of the lyrics with the vocal style being as aggressive and forward as it is, like, I understand that as an artistic decision. I guess it just didn't do anything for me. Like, I was just like, this is something.
I mean, that's
fair.
But that's like the beautiful thing about music is not the same. The same thing isn't going to resonate for everybody.
Yeah. Also, for me, it's weird how some songs I'll feel like, okay, this is overly repetitive, and then for other songs, it's like, oh, this is still repetitive, but I prefer it for this song. I don't know what's the nature of that, but I just think that as a whole piece, I wasn't too distracted by the fact that it was still going on. It could definitely be that I listened to 3 minutes of a 5-minute song, but
yeah,
it's just interesting how that goes for people.
It is interesting. It is interesting indeed. Is it time for my song?
It's time.
Sure. All right, let's see if I can get the... Let's see if I can get the bot to play for me, and if I'm gonna need to use Fredboat or not. Here we go. We're gonna try it. We're gonna try the Blasphemous Basement track and see if it works.
We're gonna do it live.
Do it live. Fuck it. Oh my god, it's really fucking up today.
Yeah. So I just need to use Fredboat. So yeah. Is Fredboat? Fredboat's already in call. Cool. So. Hi there. Oh, no. YouTube links aren't supported. I am crying.
Oh, God. It's not working.
It's not working. Fredboat, you are cringe.
Cringe.
I could... Aw, man.
I could sing it.
We're going 3 bots deep. You know it's a banger episode when we gotta pull out the 3rd bot.
Help me. Man, I love sneaking around in Baldur's Gate.
No, it's not. This freaking bot, man. Unfortunate. Let's go!
Hey.
So that was We Feast by Blasphemous Basement, the very prolific avant-garde noise free jazz rock group that does not get enough credit for what they do. I think that what they do is very interesting, and I could see them developing a bit more of a following. That track is off of their album Tales from the Beyond, which is like their first, I would call that their like first proper studio effort where everything was kind of meticulously put together. And while I think that that record does have its shortcomings, I think that that's an incredibly strong track that kind of shows their potential and what they can do moving forward as they develop as songwriters. So, yeah, Laz, what did you think?
I enjoyed this. It was very crunchy. You know, it felt like a substantial meal. There was a lot going on. I really loved the guitar tones. Multiple. The vocals were interesting. I was engaged. Let me put it that way. I was thoroughly engaged with this song.
Yeah. The vocal mixing is just kind of bizarre. Like, if anything, I'd want it to be pulled back a little bit, but it's just so interesting. I'm just like, what am I listening to?
Absolutely. Also, congrats. I think you're now at the record for the most tracks played on the podcast by a single artist.
Let's go. What was the record before?
I think it was Fishy playing Nick Cave.
That's so good. I'm glad that you broke the record, because that's funny.
Fishy playing Nick Cave, like, what, three times or something?
Yeah.
And now I have played you guys four Blasphemous Basement tracks or whatever.
Yeah, Fishy has to be gay for Nick Cave. I know it. I feel it.
Aren't
in my
we all?
Heart.
But, Billy, what did you think? What did you think of the absolutely insanity of We Feast?
I know we've listened to some of the other stuff before. This one, I think that the it's pretty driving throughout. Like, if anything, I can really enjoy the. I think Laz described this track really well. It's engaging. It has that crunch. It has those audio features that are in the background. So I just can enjoy all of that. I don't know how much I actually like the track itself, but I think that this is really something that I could like see coming back to, at least more than the others, at least.
Yeah. I think that it's one of their catchiest tracks, because it's got that guitar riff gets stuck in your head.
It does, yeah. It really drives the whole song. It's so driving. I really did enjoy the instrumentals for this one.
Yes. I'm happy we've got the Blasphemous Basement hit, and I'm happy to take the record. I look forward to holding this record while never playing anything that sounds remotely like anything else I've played by them. That's the challenge right now.
What's the next song from them that you're gonna play?
That's a good question. Probably not something this episode. One Blasphemous Basement song per episode at the maximum. But it might be something from one of their ambient records. I might pull something from one of those. So that'll be interesting.
You think they'll do a collab with Nick Cave?
I would be very surprised if they managed to pull that off. I want to see Blasphemous Basement Les Claypool collab. That's what I really want to see. It's time for Billy's song.
Yes. I hope you guys are ready for 14 minutes of pure... I don't know what it's pure of.
Wow, that sounds great. Incidentally, and totally coincidentally, I have to take a shit.
All right. Well, I guess you could do it to this song. It's gonna be weird.
Oh yeah. Let's go.
All right, you can you play it for me? I don't know the commands for this thing. I put it there.
dare you interrupt his pooping?
Yeah, sorry.
Yeah.
If I could say one thing about it real quick, this is Weather Day. Weather Day is I don't know if you remember, Laz, but I played Lola's Pocket PC for the Christmas track. And Weather Day is a solo Swedish act by that same artist. So there's going to be a lot of strong noise pop, as they say, and some elements mixed with the strengths found in emo. That's the description. I like that description.
Okay.
I like emo.
I'm into it. What emo I'm not into crazy. Is somehow I can't right click right now. Jesus Christ. It's always something today.
You can't right click if you're taking a poop. That's the rule.
Yeah.
Yeah. You messed yourself up. Never shit again. That was your first mistake.
He probably failed No Poop July.
Oh, We'll be right back.
14 minutes already. That's weird. That was My Sputnik Sweetheart by Weather Day. I realized I didn't say the title of the song. Yeah, what did you guys think? A little bit of a journey.
That was really cool. I liked the way that it fluidly moved between sections. Like, it had several different moods, and it moved between them so fluidly. And I think there's a reason that this album is one that's so enduring for people who are into emo, especially stuff from the past 5 years or so. Because this record came out in, like, 2019 or 2021, right? I don't know.
I'm pretty sure it was pretty recent.
Because I know it's within the past 5 years, but I can't remember what the exact year was.
Yeah, 2019. Which I
2019. So, like, because, like, emo music in general, it's like it had its heyday in, like, the late 90s, early 2000s. Yes. But it's always cool to see people coming in and doing things that are very much still within the spirit of the genre, but, like, also continue to develop and really push the tropes and just sort of the overall energy of it to the absolute creative limit. And yeah, I loved a lot of what this did, and this has encouraged me to go revisit that album, because I listened to it a while ago and I wasn't huge on it, but I am very excited to go back and revisit it.
Yeah, and I would also definitely recommend some of Weather Day's other stuff, for sure. Like, from My Pocket PC, Weather Day is still making other songs, just with, like, by other names. And it's just, like you said, just being kind of taking genres and taking sounds and just doing unique stuff with things that were done a little bit ago. I definitely think that emo was very poppy before, and it doesn't necessarily have to be. But there's plenty of the stuff that I have played that's emo has sometimes some poppy elements, but I really love some of the stuff that this artist does is so fun and just like a musical treat to your ears.
Yeah, definitely.
What did you think, Les?
I'd prefer to treat my cock.
A musical please, treat to my cock.
Please treat it. It's infected.
Oh, God.
Shit. No. I really enjoyed this, man. I don't even... I wasn't ready for this. I was just... I feel bad because I wasn't really analyzing it in any effective way. I was just really just vibing, you know? So I don't even know what I would say about it other than this was a great experience and I had a good time.
Nice. Yeah, I mean, I think your first listen, there's not going to be much analyzing for the song. And even like a couple listens later, it's just... At this point, I vibe out too. Like, it's so fun to go from section to section, and then when you think the song is over, like the section, another section, like all the motifs, all the light motifs from previous sections start coming back, and it's like, I could see someone arguing that this should just be like part of an album, but I love this just being one compressed song of each section coming back to each other. And then, you know, finally, just at the end, it just songs out.
Yeah. That's what it's all about, man. The graphics.
You know, it's all about the Mets, baby!
It's the graphics.
All about the Mets, baby!
God, don't tell me there isn't a Charizard cover for this deck. What the fuck?
Yeah. That's fucking crazy.
Yeah, it's cringe. All right. I guess I'm up next.
Yeah.
And you know what that means? I'm pretty sure... Weezer? I could play Weezer, shit.
Something off of Winter. Season's Winter.
Yeah, or I could play a B-side. They have a lot of good B-sides.
This is true.
But no, this is a song that you've probably all heard in some form or other. Because it was a big hit at the time, but that was the single version. This is the extended version. It's very different. Not really, but I have an excuse to play it because it technically has under 10 million listens. So, I sometimes just put this on while I'm driving and I just vibe to it because it's good driving music, I think. All right. Anyway, this is the original extended version of Atomic Dog by George Clinton. Are you ready?
No.
Of course, George Clinton was a legendary frontman for Parliament Funkadelic. So, yes. Let's go.
Do the dog catcher, baby, do the dog catcher.
Dogs.
Dog in me.
Why must
Sonic Dog. Neutron Dog. Metromedia Dog.
Metal Dog. Right, that was the original extended version of Atomic Dog by George Clinton. And how do you feel about the Business Dog, Aleph?
You know I got that dog in me. They say I got that dog in me. Now, that was cool. I actually don't think I've ever heard that song. Like, even, like, the single cut of it. It was enjoyable. It was very much a vibing out to every kind of... everything that's kind of going on that's kind of wacky. Yeah, no. We just vibing out here. And enjoyable. I could see how you enjoy this on, like, drives and stuff. But... overall, I don't know how much I'd return to this on my own time, but I would definitely not be mad if somebody put it on.
Okay, fair. Billy, what did you think?
I think he wants to fuck the dog.
Billy, it's a metaphor for how people are dogs and people be fucking like dogs. It's a metaphor. You don't understand.
No, God. He's the dog and he's sexy dog. I want to fuck the dog. That dog let me into the dog butthole. That's the dog.
Yeah. Are you okay?
No.
Billy's gonna lose it.
This song just makes me want to fuck the dog.
As long as it happens on the podcast, it's content.
I don't want to fuck the dog, I swear. I don't know. It was nice to vibe out to. I definitely wouldn't put this on myself. I can't hear someone want to fuck a dog for so long. If I did want to hear that, I'd turn on, what's his name?
That was a cat.
Oh, that was a cat. Yeah.
That was Shane Dawson, and that was a cat.
Well,
yeah.
If different. I wanted to listen to someone be a furry, well, not even be a
then
furry.
Then you'd listen to Your Movie Sucks.
If I wanted to listen to someone who likes bestiality, I'd listen to Shane Dawson, you know?
No, you wouldn't.
No, I wouldn't. What the dog doing?
What the dog doing?
What's the dog doing? Butter dog. Dog with the butter.
Dog with the butter on it. Yo, the butter dog goes crazy. I found the other day it popped up on my beat butter dog type beat. It was pretty scrumptious. Hottest track of 2023.
All right. I'm into it.
Yeah.
I guess you're up next.
Yeah. We're going to get a little bit less weird here. We're going to go with some folk music. This is one of my favorite bands, The Collection. David Wimbish is, like, he's probably, like, my favorite lyricist at the moment, maybe of all time. But I just, like, I love the way that he writes lyrics, and while there's not much to this musically, and, like, it's not super advanced musically. The music, in my opinion, it serves kind of the perfect balance to just let the songwriting shine. So here's that. This is Bandages of Time by The Collection.
I always try to leave a little part of me off somewhere deep inside you. But the ones that I've been breaking off lately just seem so far from my truth. Well, I watched your eyes both part in tears like they were Moses. and your savior standing off on distant shores, wondering if I had ever really noticed the man I was before, if he was there anymore. And I always thought I could predict both our futures from the way your lips went sailing. Oh, but my tongue is a rudder too, and it sent me off to find another island. Well, I watched you wish that you had never even met me, and for your sake, I guess I wish the same. I spent 3 long days inside of the belly of a whale of your blame. Forgot my real name. And when we're born, tectonic plates move until we grow up to a mountain. All our actions break away our youth, but we still dream of hidden fountains. I'm sorry that I chipped away what makes you strong. Well, I was searching for myself beneath your stones, but I just found there is no cure for all our longings in a temporary home. So I left you alone. And I wove with your pain, beating hard against my heart till it went faster. And the sky was full of flames, and the sun was tossing rays like God's laughter. But how am I supposed to learn to walk on water when I am the only reason for the storm and the only thing that I've called the master keeps changing its form since the day I was born.
So that's Bandages of Time by The Collection. As I mentioned, David Wimbish, one of my favorite lyricists. What did you think, Billy?
No thoughts, head empty. It was whimsical. And I was whimsically rushed into the ocean just listening to this guy singing. And it was cool.
That's about how I feel about it a lot. Like the first couple times I listened to it, I was just like, I'm just chilling on the ocean. We're just We're just caught up in the journey.
Yeah, like my old friend used to say, life is a highway, and I want to ride it all night long.
Ka-chow.
Yeah. Wow.
When Lightning McQueen said ka-chow, I really felt that.
Yeah.
I too was alive in the mid-2000s.
I too alive.
Put that on a t-shirt. Oh, man.
Ka-chow. But yeah, no, Laz, what did you think of it?
I think, therefore I am.
True.
I like this. As Billy was implying, it's a very unassuming, just very sweet and very very soothing, just a folk track that I can just like turn off my brain to and let it ease away my troubles and my worried mind.
Yeah. Just kind of washes you away. Yeah. Very lovely stuff, yeah. Very different from everything else that we've played today. Probably a good pit stop.
Yeah, it's a good palate cleanser.
Yes. And then now you're going to come in with some dark ambient or something for your last track.
You'll see.
It's me, so I don't have dark ambient. I'm sorry.
Damn. Billy, how could you not have dark ambient? This was like the entire reason that I came is for Billy's dark ambient picks.
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
Billy's not Laz's, ambient. Billy's.
I'm gonna try to do this right. I'm gonna try to do it live. Alright.
Do it live! Fuck it.
Alright, here is a band called Carissa's Weird. So that's how you know it's a weird song, guys.
Oh, and weird is spelled incorrectly.
Is it?
No, in the band's name. Yeah. I'm familiar with this band. Yeah.
I think
it's intentional.
I don't think weird is spelled Oh, no, it is. That's funny.
Yep.
I intentionally spelt it right. I didn't even mean to do that. It's funny. All right, so this is ignorant piece of shit.
Faster, I can imagine the way.
That was Curtis is weird. Ignorant piece of shit. What did you guys think?
Did you fucking call me, motherfucker?
Fuck off. Never mind. I don't really know what you think.
No. Yeah, no, it was good. I like this band. I pick them up and put them down once in a while. You know, like low-key indie tracks that are, you know, great for going on walks. I prefer to go on walks while listening to this band. I feel like it's a good band for just sort of like dissociating, really.
This is the dissociating smoothie.
Yeah, and I don't like to do that while driving, so it's better for walking.
Yeah, dissociating while driving is like just second only to drinking and driving as far as the dangers go.
Oh yeah.
The three D's of influenced driving: drinking, dabbing, and dissociating.
And D's nuts.
The four D's. Very nice.
But yeah, I like this. Hadn't heard the song before.
It was very enjoyable. I'm always a sucker for whenever they mix violin in this way, because it always gives it so much more of a. It transports me out to, like, I don't know, rural Pennsylvania or something like that, where everyone's got, like, the most dated clothes on that you've ever seen, and I'm like, ah, yes, this is a party. But this is very low-key, and it was very enjoyable, and it was just, like, I think the best word to describe this track would be pleasant. It is just an incredibly pleasant listen, and I was just like, yes, this is very, very nice. I very much enjoyed this.
Yes, for sure. It's a very smooth track after all of the other stuff that we've listened to this whole time.
Yes. We get the insane emo tracks, we get the borderline harsh noise tracks, we got the post-punk tracks, and then we got this.
Yes, as some random fucko on YouTube said over a decade ago, this is very music.
That has insane lolcat energy.
I like how you're like still like innately holding a grudge against someone. Not holding a grudge, but still keeping their
No, it just lives rent free in my brain.
Life is Roblox.
Yes.
Words of wisdom from DJ Khaled.
Yeah. The key is to make it.
The key. Tell him to bring out the lobster. Tell him to bring out the whole ocean.
The key is to call honey, honey. Honey, honey.
Honey, honey.
Where are you?
Let's go golfing.
Golf.
Man, what a quotable fellow.
Yes.
Honestly, top 10 people I'd want to have dinner with just to see.
That's gonna
dinner with DJ Khaled would be hilarious.
Absolutely.
I would be in pain the whole time.
Nah, man. And then he gives you just, like, the most insane, like, advice about promoting your art that you've ever heard. And then the next sentence is just something like, I don't know, I cannot come up with something he would say, because you cannot surpass the DJ Khaled energy. You can only match it.
Yeah, I can't match it. I can't even get there. That's completely off my wavelengths.
Yes. He's something special, man. God, dude.
Lions.
Yeah.
All right, I think on that note, we're about to wrap up and call it a day. This was the music smoothie, and
any words of wisdom before we leave, Billy?
Yeah, Billy.
Honey.
Very good wisdom.
Yeah. I've got some. Knuckles the dog was a very good dog.
This has been the Wisdom Podcast.
This is the Everything Podcast.
It's only sometimes about music.
Yeah. All right. This was the music smoothie. Make sure to tip your Gorgon.
Yes. Goodbye.
Bye. All right. And that was our latest episode of the music smoothie. Hope you enjoyed that blend. And if you like what we do and would like us to record consistently, we're currently trying to record weekly, consider donating to us on Patreon at The Music Smoothie, and follow us on Twitter at TMusicSmoothie, and we're available on Instagram and Facebook at just The Music Smoothie. All the music we use is fair use under the media criticism clause of fair use. And if you like the music we listen to but don't always have time to listen to the episode, our playlist is available on Spotify. Just type in The Music Smoothie, and you'll be able to find all the music we play. All right. That's all the music that's available on Spotify, at least. Not all of it is. I hope you guys had a great time. And have a good one. Day, morning, evening, night. Times in other dimensions as well. Yeah. All right, see ya.